Hello, Forecaster here again, and we are back for episode 210 of the Minecraft Let's Play. And as you can see, I'm here on a mountain, and my base is right over there, and this is the area where I hung out with my horse while mining around this place with the advanced miner. And the reason I'm over here is that I found something interesting, and it is a little bit of a hike in this direction, but I want to show my relative position so I just don't say I found this thing. I wanted to show how relatively close it was to my base. I've been walking around looking for caves to spelunk in, looking for appetite, because I have my tree farm has run out of fertilizer again and has stopped producing wood. So I have been looking for more appetite for it, because I need the wood to produce creosote oil so I can make more ties for wooden posts, because I'm going to need quite a lot more of those. But over here is what I found. Oop, I just found this bit of quicksand. I could probably remove this. It's not that dangerous. One block on its own, that's just knee-deep, basically. But here is an Enviromine mine shaft, and I've already been down here. I've cleared up some lava, which was, and some water. There was water flowing into the shaft. Here you can see these dark oak wood blocks I placed to block it, and here are some more. And then down here we had the lava intersecting the shaft, and it had, I assume that this bit here was generated, a little lava pool here, and then the shaft cut it off and put this wood next to the lava, and the wood simply burned, obviously. So that probably wasn't that brilliant of the generation, but we have this nice shaft, and there may be more lava around here, who knows. There's a lot of iron. There's some lava. And a open bit into, oh, look at this. Got an indoor waterfall here, pretty much. Looks like that leads up into a cave. Looks like we had some lava here as well. But yeah, I've been looking for appetite, mostly. Also, I'm searching for iron as well, which is, there is quite a bit here, so that is nice. I'm not going to mine that on camera. I'll get that later. Just want to explore for a bit. Looks like we have water from a different biome over here. It's green. Lots of lava. Lot of lava. It's kind of ruining my mine shaft. It's a bit unfortunate. I might have to fix that. The one I found, the shaft I found over by the new base, and that village has a lot less lava in it. But yeah, so the progress on the high-speed railway is being made. Although slowly, I raised it up a bit because it was going to hit some hills and then a desert. So while I was inside of a hill, I went upwards a bit. Ooh, that's funky. And as a result, it's now using a lot more posts, because the pillars are a lot higher, of course. But hopefully it won't hit any more What's it? Well, anything, any obstacles anymore is my hope. It doesn't look like there's a whole lot of appetite. Maybe I'm at the wrong height. That's some more topaz, I think. I want that. Yeah. It's topaz. Come to me. But I'm not going to remain here for much longer. Not on camera. I'm going to have a look around, see if I can actually find some appetite, mine all the iron I can find. And then we're going to meet up back at the base. And we're going to do some stuff around there. Going to have a look at the. Probably have a look at the method I'm using to produce my posts. And pack them into boxes, which is very handy. The robot uses that, of course, as I've demonstrated before. But yeah, so I will see you when I'm back at the base. And we are back, and we are in the base, of course. Now, I didn't find any appetite. I also didn't find any red limestone, which I also need. So, going to have to put that off, and unfortunately, mostly the limestone has delayed the what's it? The construction of this building for quite a while, and I hate this. Why does this happen? Can I rotate this? Yes, but it's still doing that. Right. I still don't know why that happens. There's an extra overlay that's kind of frozen. A little offset for some reason, and this has happened with the nuclear reactor overview up there as well, and it is incredibly annoying. And I don't think I last time this happened, I tried to relog and it didn't work. Anyway, I set this up, and as you can see down here, this is in regards to this. I have these average counters, and I have one here for the output, and then I have one down here for the reactor input. So, by looking at this, I can see how much power is being used, how much of it is coming from the reactor, and how much is coming from the turbine. And if neither of these are operating, that means that it is coming from these, radioisotope heat generators, which is basically free power. So, yeah, and this shows the fill levels of these three MFEs, of course. So, currently, we are using a lot of power, but this one here is still not empty. When that has emptied, of course, this is going to start emptying, and then the reactor will engage, and it will compensate for the power loss, hopefully, until it runs out of fuel. So that is new, and it is pretty neat. It works great unless this happens, and I think to fix this, I'm going to need to restart the server, which I obviously don't want to do right now because I'm recording. So yeah, now over here I've been using this setup to produce and package my wooden posts, and I can demonstrate quickly how that happens, although it's not super interesting, but you know, I've had this carpenter here produce tons of wooden ties, and I've been using logs, putting them into here, turning them into charcoal to generate creosote oil. Now, unfortunately, I've run out of wood pretty much, so because like I said before, the tree farm doesn't work. I have a few wooden ties here, though. I can take them down and turn them into posts, packaged into boxes. Now, I have this packager here. It's configured to accept any 8 items and then use a box to package them. And that is put through the stamping table and turned into one of these. Now, I would put the wooden ties into this hopper and not directly into the stamping table. Unfortunately, doing so will allow the packager to grab them from the hopper and turn them into packages, which will then turn into a box with 8 ties in it, which is not what I want. So I have to put them directly into the stamping table. If I had another hopper, I would probably put it here to have that feed the stamping table. Like we discovered in an earlier episode, if this overflows, it will start spitting items out, which is bad. I have 2 speed upgrades in this, but that is not always enough to keep up with the stamping table. I'm going to do that to have this fill up. I've put all the ores and stuff that I found down in that mine shaft that I dug up into my ore crushers, and they are both running in parallel. Basically, I have a lot of backlog of stuff. Yeah. I think I should move this over here and then have another hopper in between like I have here, because I don't think this is even got an even distribution. That might have something to do with that. Okay, this is empty. I'm going to turn that off and then turn this on. It's going to start putting posts into here, and it's going to start packaging them, and then they're going to end up here. Pretty simple. And now we're having, the coal ends up in here, which is actually fine because I'm going to want to grab this, and I'm going to put some coal. You grab some more from over here. Put it into the coke oven. Turn into coal coke, so that we can generate some more creosote. So we get more ties. We need the ties. And it turns out finding red limestone has been very difficult. Like I said, I know I've seen it somewhere. I actually have some appetite. Let's turn this into fertilizer and go recharge the tree farm. Just give us some, and then we need some more sand. I would use ash, but I don't have any, unfortunately. Or I have very little. But this should do for a while. I need to find another appetite vein somewhere. They're not, because of custom origin, they're not super common, but the veins themselves are pretty large instead. So now it should be chopping down these trees existing, and it should start producing more of this stuff, hummus. And apple, oak, pollen. The only reason I can think of that would be produced is because the bees happen to be close enough to some of these leaves. I wouldn't think they were close enough. Can I make a treeolizer to analyze this? Need copper, any glass panes, and some redstone and a diamond. That is perfectly doable. Let's do that. I want to analyze this pollen and see what kind of attributes it has. I've never really done anything with the tree breeding stuff. I haven't touched that yet. We probably will eventually, because it's something to do. And I also want some of the fancy types of trees one can get through forestry. Now let's see, we have some redstone. We need a couple of glass panes, which I should have right there. Two of those. And then we just need a diamond. We should also go up and check on the bees, see if they have produced more silky combs yet. I haven't checked on them in a while, and the server has actually been running for quite a while, because it seems that I forgot to turn it off last night. So whoops. But yeah, we have more than two stacks of these, which is pretty great. So let's throw those into the centrifuge and should be able to get a lot of silk wisps out of these. Maybe should even have put a hopper on that. Actually, I can repurpose this hopper. Let's see. Make that face that way, and then put those in there. And then we have our treeolizer. Restore this recipe back to that. And then this also runs on honey, which we should have some in here. And by some, I mean quite a lot. And then we can throw this in. And average matures faster, height small, girth 1x1, yield lowest, sappiness lowest, not fireproof, and no effect. So I guess I don't really know how tree breeding works, but I assume you put multiple types of trees nearby each other, and then you have the bees pollinate them, so you need to have bees working nearby, and they will hopefully be cross-pollinated and produce other types of trees, or trees with varying genomes, one would assume. Pretty sure that would be how it works. So we'll probably have a look at that. I'm going to have a kind of a green, like I said, I'm going to have a greenhouse type building or area set up, which is probably going to be basically a raised platform with grass on it and split into segments of some description, and then there's going to be a little building somewhere with some machines in it, like a carpenter and a centrifuge and all that, and there are going to be apiaries spread out across that area for bees to work in, and then we're going to have trees planted, and then probably a segment of that is going to be automated tree farms. So yeah, that is the plan. That might be the next building I design after the museum has been constructed. Which is going to have to, again, be delayed until I manage to find some stupid red limestone. And there are a couple of other things that I need to... Well, the aspect ratio of this, of the window, is wrong. I don't have it in full screen. And I don't think changing it now would be a good idea, so there are going to be black bars on the top and bottom of the video, which is unfortunate, but not something that I can fix right now. I forgot that the client crashed, and I forgot to put it into full screen after I restarted it. Actually died in the mine shaft because I ran out of water, as you can see from the death counter. And when I respawned, or was about to respawn back here, the client crashed because of some error with the better storage backpacks. So that was annoying, and wait for the client to restart. What is that? Oh, turret base, right. Tree. Why does that match? Oh, there are trees everywhere. It's a quote or something. That's why that matches tree. That's odd. What is that? Tree moss. I don't think I've seen that. But yeah, basically waiting for that. That's going to produce a bunch of silk whiffs. Might even be enough for another backpack. Although, maybe not. Alright, I will be back when the silky combs and the silky propolis are all processed, and we'll see what we have as a result of that, and I'll fix the ratio of the video. So I will be back in just a bit. Alright, I'm back. The propolis has been processed, and it looks like we are going to get... We do have enough woven silk to make another upgraded backpack, and I don't know, the ones we have left, it stands between these two, and I wouldn't say that I use the, or that the Digger's backpack gets used a whole lot. I'm a bit more concerned about this one, I think, because I would like to have more weapons and more ammo and stuff with me, but I can't really because I'm limited by the size of this. So, we're going to upgrade the warrior's backpack, and to do so, we're going to dump the contents in there. You can set the mode to neutral, or normal, or whatever, and we are going to put it right there. The silk sheets like that, and then we need the diamond goes there, and then we have another sheet, and then we are upgrading. Also, when I said the next building is going to have farms, or automated farms, I meant not just tree farms. There are going to be other types of automated farms as well, like the orchard we have now, and the peat bog, and probably maybe other things. We'll have to wait and see. But yeah, I'll probably also set up a sprinkler system with water supply. Maybe I should find one of those water sources and build the farm on top of or next to that so I can have better water supply that doesn't rely on water tanks, which take up a lot of space comparatively. Let's restore this to that. And now we have our upgraded warrior's backpack, woven warrior's backpack. So now we can dump all of this stuff out, have it go into the backpack before we lock it. Still hunting for wither skulls, of course. I can make some stuff out of those. I should make some more ammo for my rifle. Come on. There we go. Oh. I hate when that happens. Right. So ammo for that is just this. And then I am probably going to have, say, 2 stacks of these. Should be sufficient using lead nuggets for ammo is pretty efficient. Produces 4 rounds. And lead is not super useful for many other things. If you recall, I made custom recipes for these. I could use steel or titanium to produce a lot more, but lead is a good middle ground. And like I said, it's not used for much else. Making bullets out of copper could do as well. But yeah. Also, we forgot that this thing has multiple pages. And we just looked at the first one, which is basically a summary. So here we can see the active and passive traits, or active and inactive. Growth, light, soil, plains. Tolerates plains and supports palms, which is apples. Fruits, apple, family, palms. I don't exactly know what this means. The soil. I assume it means that it likes this biome and it doesn't really tolerate any other, but I'm not entirely sure. Then we have the production. It produces apples, of course, because it's an apple oak. We don't know any mutations. And then the final page is the classification and stuff, and some quotes. Common tree species whose apple-bearing properties are the subject of much song and dance. I can't say I've heard a lot of songs about apple trees. Really. Or maybe I have, just don't remember them specifically. Now, what do I do with this? I suppose I will throw it in here. It's got a lot of junk in here. But yeah. Oh, this has gotten stuck as well. It looks like there are 2 hours and 50 minutes left. In some seconds, I would say, of that. Setting up the new power plant is going to be interesting. I'm going to have a, instead of all of the circuitry I have, and we can quickly pop down and take a look at that. Instead of all the circuitry I happen to have that is controlling the reactor, I might have talked about this before. I'm going to replace it with a computer system, or a server probably, that is going to monitor all of the tanks. It's going to monitor the status of the rotors and the fuel level in the reactor itself. So it's going to replace these basically, which are kind of buggy. So all of this stuff basically, is going to be replaced by a single server. And then I'm going to have that on a network, and I'm going to allow hooking up, design a terminal program that is going to fetch data from the server and display the reactor status. And that is also going to work with a tablet, is the idea, so that I can have a portable device with me that I can use to quickly check the status of the reactor. Wait. Why is this should be running? Why is this so low? So because this is low, this should be keeping the. This should be outputting redstone, and it is. Like I seem to recall, I told it to. Yeah, if this is lower than 25%, it's going to keep the cooling system from running, or the coolant processing from running, so this doesn't run out, so these don't start running unevenly. But why isn't this refilling? Is the reactor not running? Is the. No, the overheating counter can't have activated. No, it hasn't activated at all lately. So that's not it. Oh, it's out of fuel. Well, then, that is probably why nothing is running, and that was the right floor. That's not good because that means we will be overusing power and don't have any extra power generation, so we will slowly run out. That is not good at all, so we're going to have to fix that. Should have a spare set, and then I'm going to have to make some more off camera to replenish my stock of spare fuel rods. Well, then, it was good I checked because by the looks of that stupid buggy panel up there, it looked like it still had fuel left. It wasn't running. Can't tell if it's actually says zero or if it's which one is correct. Stupid thing. All right. So it's a very much a good thing that I decided to go down here and check up on the system. So now this should be replenishing. And this is why this check exists. Because of course this won't refill if the reactor can't run. So that check needs to be there from stopping the coolant from running out completely. Yeah, although it would probably run out pretty evenly, assuming there's an even amount in that tank, actually. Which there may very well not be, or most likely won't be. No, that's not really. Really. If it's below 100, it wouldn't be split evenly. The first hopper to activate would take all of it up to 100. And then even if it was just slightly above 100, the next hopper would get whatever is left. So one of them would not get enough. So then one would run out first, and probably some stuff would be destroyed. Of course, nothing permanent would happen, but oh, well, crap. I forgot I still had the depleted rods on me. Damn. I lost some experience there, but it's not a big deal. Let's get these. Didn't mean to take the sword, but whatever. Oh, right. I should put on the hazmat suit, shouldn't I? Oh well. I'm going to end the episode here, and I'm going to continue my search for radiation, no, red limestone and apatite. And hopefully I will find some soon so that I can actually finish the building and get on with the next one. So, with that, I will see you next time. Hi! Welcome to the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Or leave a comment telling me either way, because any sort of user engagement makes YouTube more likely to show the video in searches or suggestions. Now, did you know that I have a page on my website that has a list of all the shows I have on YouTube, even past ones, along with their respective publishing schedules, as well as a list of all of the past videos that is searchable by series, tags, or title. And I also have a subscription system that is entirely separate from YouTube's that allow you to subscribe to specific shows from me, as well as stream notifications, such as when I schedule or start a stream. So if that sounds useful, do go and check that out. There are links in the description.